Hi, this is Ricky Sun. I'm a Pi consultant. In this video, I'm going to talk about the Pi connector for OPC UA. I wanted to get data from OPC UA servers, which is from Ignition System. I do not have my original old Pi interface option because I cannot use Pi interface to connect to OPC UA. This isn't a interface that can do that. It can connect to OPC DA or HDA, but there's no OPC UA option to connect to from the interface side. So I look at Pi connectors because Pi connector seems like it has graphical interface. It has been around for quite a few years. Adapter just came out. Well, I guess it's a year or so. By the way, I'm going to talk about adapters later too. But connectors, Pi connector for OPC UA. And then when I first installed, I got problems with the port. I have to install different components of the Pi connectors, like the Pi connector relay or the Pi data collection managers. Those are different components that you have to set up, and you have to open port, and then you have to request IT to open the port for you. Exactly which port is necessary to open, and then you have to tell them so that you can get it running. I think that's the most challenging part for me, is to first understand the architecture. And this is a video to maybe share with you some challenges, the characteristic of Pi connectors, and also which port you need to open to get it working. If you look at my screen, I got a control network here. And in my control network, I have my Ignition System, OPC UA, and then I'm going to install Pi connector for OPC UA inside the control network. After I did that, I was able to connect to the source, to the OPC UA, by specifying the path of opc.tcp, that kind of thing, to get it set up. So it say, okay, it can connect. Middle is the DMC. We install the connector relay and the data collection manager on the DMC because I don't want to put it in the business network, because IT will not allow us to bridge between control network and business. Open the firewall between them needs a lot of paperwork and approval. So we have to do in stages. That's why we have to hop to DMC and then from DMC to business. And that's why we put those two components inside DMC. And then there are three ports you need to open. And I installed both of these software on the same machine. On that same machine, I need to tell IT, hey, 5671 to be opened, because it is listening. And then 5672 for Pi data collection managers. And also this custom port, 5461. It can be something else for you when you install Pi data collection manager. So this is customizable, and you need to tell ITA, I need this port to be open temporary if you like. But I leave it open. I didn't ask IT to close it. But this is important because you need to register your connector to the data collection manager, and then so that the website can see it, and then they say approve. So you need to do that step in order to get everything running. So this free port is necessary to be open, and they are listening when you install those connector relay and data collection manager. And then I think when you are familiar with business network stuff, the data archive, which should already have 5450 open, and then also 5457 for your AF server. Once you have these port open, you would be able to set up your graphical interface for the Pi connectors. You can overcome less obstacle because this is the major one. You couldn't get anything to work if you don't have ports open. Let's talk about the characteristic of the Pi connectors for OPC UA. And when I was looking at the manual and doing a lot of research on it so that I can provide my customer the best possible opinion, because of the architectures and the requirement is dynamic, we have to know all the options in order to support our clients. So I think you might be encountering that, so I want to share that. First, Pi connectors allow you to create AF structure. in your AEF servers. And I want to point out it's exactly the same as your OPC UA structure. When you do that, you replicate that structure to your AEF server. You can select the tag you like, but the structure will be identical. I don't know if it is the pros or the cons, because that AEF structure isn't really used, like AEF structure is not very user-friendly, and we want to change that AF structure. I don't know, maybe we just need the tag to be created. We don't really need the OPC UA structure. And there is a tag only option. That one is nice. You can load your OPC UA no ID into a tag list, and then you can make your Pi connector to only do tag only. Doesn't need to create the AF structure. It just create the tag you want in the list and then start collecting data. At least something is in AF without your effort. The next one is like when I select the data inside the OPC UA, like I could select the data from the data collection manager, like website. I would say this option for me to filter the data that I want. I can only get the temperature. I can also filter different identical asset, just temperature or pressure. I can use a star to filter. I can do a query like inside the graphical interface in the admin page. I could customize that query so that I can select the data I want for tag creation, because I don't want to create all the tags. I only want to select subset of the tag in the OPC UA. I don't really want to create all the tags, and I'm going to talk about adapters later, but create all the tags is like, if you are EA, you can create all the tags, but if you're not EA, we don't want to create all the tags. So it's a nice option to have to be able to filter more for data selection. The other pros is it has a good graphical interface, because it just lets you see, okay, I'm connecting to the Pi server, AEF servers, and then I am seeing the data from the Pi connector relay, the data source, and then connectors. Kind of step by step, your eyes, and you can troubleshoot. There's a diagnostic, you can look at logs there. Everything is inside the data collection manager. Like, I think this is kind of like a central thing you can look at to troubleshoot and identify issues and etc., right? And configuration as well. So that is great. That's a great thing. Also doesn't scare us away. Customer doesn't like to programming or command line, you know, something like Pi interface in interface configuration utility would be nice, because you can start stop. Graphical interface is nice for customer. Let's talk about the bad side about the Pi connect. After reading so much manual, I discovered there is no high availability options for the Pi connectors. So you have to use one connectors, one Pi connector relay, one data collection manager. So everything is one, no XA. You don't have XA option. And also, you know, there is no manual backfilling. So you cannot specify a star time and time to backfill the data you wanted. And if OPC UA has the historical component, you can go back. It just backfill the buffer data. What it means is like when there's this connection, buffer will hold the data and then send the data, so we fill the gap. There is no backfill option like the Pi interface for OPCHDA. You can backfill some 1 year of data, let's say. The other cons is when I configure it, I need to open a lot of port, and I feel like it's a lot of component. Why do I need so many things? So I think that's a con, because I have to work with IT to open so many ports, and I have to fully understand the architecture. It takes me some time to read the manual and figure out. If you watch this video, hopefully this helped you solve some of the challenges without reading or spend time pay attention to the manual. And that's kind of the cons on the Pi connector for OPC UA. My client actually tell me, like, before he was thinking, okay, I want Pi connector for OPC UA because of the graphical interface, and it has been a few years, and then kind of more known to him versus the adapters. But without the backfilling capability of manual backfill the data, it is kind of a problem to him, and he need to figure out the backfilling capability and where can he do that if he utilize Pi Connector for OPC UA. So that's the problem we're facing, but we are also exploring the option of the Pi adapters for OPC UA. I'm going to explore that and talk about it in the next video too. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe as well as hitting the bell icon. I'll see you next week. Bye.